exhalation followed by passive inhalation. That means जोर से झटके से सांस फेंकना है and inhalation is going to happen on its own. That means if I start like this, that's wrong. Why? Because I'm inhaling at the same time. So that means inhalation should happen on its own. I'm just concerned with forceful exhalation. That is the first thing of the pranayama. The second thing of the pranayama is the force. Now you know many people are doing this pranayama, but the force is inadequate. The force should be of that nature that even if I have a candle flame lit 6 inches away from my nostrils, that should blow out. अब हम मोमबत्ती को रख के बैठ नहीं सकते, इट्स वेरी इम्प्रैक्टिकल. सो इन माई यूट्यूब वीडियोज आई हैव ओवर 1000 वीडियोज ऑन यूट्यूब. यू कैन जस्ट गो ऑन टू youtube.com/ramneekwe एंड आई हैव ट्राइड टू डेमोंस्ट्रेट द पाम टेस्ट. आई हैव इवन शोन हाउ यू कैन डू दिस प्राणायाम व्हाइल गोइंग आउट फॉर योर इवनिंग वॉक ओवर देयर. सो द पाम टेस्ट इज दैट यू कीप योर पाम अबाउट 6 inches क्लोज टू योर नॉस्ट्रल एंड व्हेन यू ब्लो द एयर ऑफ you should feel the pressure of air in your palm region. If you can feel the pressure of air in your palm region, you're doing fine. If not, you're going to work on the pressure. Because when you're going to be exhaling with a lot of pressure, what's going to happen? Your abdomen will go in and your lungs will contract. So if there are any toxins stuck up in your lungs, mucus in your lungs, that's going to be dispelled through your nostrils. So the force should be adequate. If the force is not adequate, you will not get the desired result. Right now I was in the US, so I remember there was a guy in this yoga center, his name was Jack, and he said, you know, Mr. Wade, I can do this pranayama like 500 times. That's easy, not a big problem. And he went on like this. I said, Jack, force is missing. So the counts are there, but the force is missing. So if the force is missing, you will not get the desired benefit what you're looking for. So the force should be of that great intensity that even if a candle flame is lit 6 inches away from the nostril, it should blow off. Or if you have kept your palm about 6 inches close to your nostril, you should feel the pressure of air in your palm region. Now in my book titled The Miracles of Pranayama, I have spoken about 3 stages of Kapalbhati. I have tried to compare this pranayama with the speed of a train. When a train just leaves the platform, it will dheere dheere chalti hai, like so hum kya keh sakte hain, we can compare the first stage of pranayama with the speed of a train which is just running at its very slow speed. That means a gap of 1 second between 2 forceful exhalations. That will be taken as stage 1. Matlab kya hua? Something like this. That is stage 1. Okay. So you saw the force was there. Agar main iski tulna mein aise karu, right. So we need to feel that the force is adequate so that my lungs are contracting nicely, and if so there are any toxins in my lung area, they will be dispelled through my nostrils. That is stage 1. Now after doing a couple of rounds of stage 1, we move on to relaxed breathing. Ki thoda thak gaye, koi baat nahi, relax kiya. Relaxed breathing mein kya tha? Breathe in to the count of 3, breathe out to the count of 3. Simply relax yourself. Then we move on to stage 2. Now in stage 2, our train is running at its normal speed. Like normal speed. So we would reduce the gap from 1 second to half a second now. That is our stage 2 of Kapalbhati. That would go something like this.
That's stage two.
Right.
After doing stage two, you again get back to your relaxed breathing cycle, whereby you're inhaling to the count of three, exhaling three, relaxing yourself. And then you move on to stage three. That is called as a rapid Kapalbhati round. That means now your train is running at a stop speed. Like that. That means there's going to be no gap between two portion exhalations now. Ab kya hoga, do exhalations ke beech mein no gap at all. So that would turn out to be something like this. That was stage three, okay? So, now Kapalbhati is a very important pranayama for problems as Ram rightly spells and I got messed up. It's a very important pranayama for cancer, diabetes, asthma, for low blood pressure. Now people with high BP, they only do stage one, and that also with just 50% force. Because you know, many times I get cancer patients who get this, कैंसर के साथ तो बीपी भी है और कैंसर के लिए तो इम्पोर्टेंट है पर बीपी है क्या करूं मैं कहना चाहता है फाइन डोंट डू स्टेज टू डोंट डू स्टेज थ्री डू स्टेज वन बट जस्ट गो विथ 50% फोर्स दैट मीन द फुल फोर्स वुड बी समथिंग लाइक दिस
एंड 50% वुड बी
यू गॉट इट. So people with high BP, they can do up to about 50% force, okay? So let's do a couple of rounds of Kapalbhati before we move on to the next pranayama. Relax yourself and breathe in and breathe out.
I'm sorry.